So it's a nice morning. It's the fifth day of the Simbang Gabi. I hope you guys are all prepped up for the morning. Well, I'm Rachel Del Mar, your host for Health Central. And all this week, we're going to be at the Maya Kitchen. Our first guest for this morning is Ms. Virgit Bueno, the author of the book, Healthy Cooking for Healthy Eating, which she co-authored with Maya Kitchen. Good morning, Ms. Bueno. How are you?
I'm fine. Good morning, Rachel.
Okay, please tell us what inspired both Maya Kitchen and yourself to author this book.
Well, actually, it's very important that, you know, when I explain to my clients that I go into details. I cannot just be talking about a food plan without really telling them how to go about with the cooking.
Okay, so by profession, you're actually a dietitian.
I'm a dietitian, right? Yes, right.
Okay, now we want to know, what's the book specifically designed for the clients of yours so that they don't have to keep coming back? They can just buy your book? Or it's just something like a hobby that you and Maya Kitchen decided to just bring out since a lot of cookbooks?
Well, actually, it was designed for my clients, and it just came one time. Somebody from my kitchen called me up in the office, and then asked me to do this, and I was really happy to do this for them.
Does it really take that long to make a cookbook, like 3 years?
No, not really, but you know, I had to do this in between the work that I do in the office.
Okay, that's right. So always hang on to your daytime job while writing books. Now, please explain to the viewers out there what healthy cooking has to do with healthy eating.
Well, healthy cooking really is very important because you can be sabotaged when you're trying to eat healthy if you don't prepare the food the right way.
You're saying preparing the food the right way, that means what in
particular? Well, of course, we have to be conscious that we have to cook with less fat, less salt.
You know,
well,
not too much sugar.
Sugar, yes.
And of course, try to do without the MSG, right? Okay, now, how do we change the way we cook to have like a healthier form of cooking? How can it be healthier?
Well, we can do a lot of, we can modify the method of cooking, we can make substitutions.
Substitutions, for example?
For example, like when you use, instead of using the regular oil, you can use the polyunsaturated oil.
Did you get that, people? Polyunsaturated oil. What are the benefits of the polyunsaturated oil?
Well, first of all, I'd like to explain the example of the polyunsaturated oil. We have the corn oil, we have the safflower oil, we have the soybean oil. Now, the polyunsaturated oil will act on the bad cholesterol. It lowers the bad cholesterol.
Mm. Okay.
So we can still use oil in cooking, but we have to make sure that we use the right kind.
The right kind of oil.
Yes. But the bottom line really is using less fat for cooking.
Less fat.
Yes, right.
Okay, since it's virtually hard to cook without oil, just to go for the polyunsaturated oil. But is there any difference in taste with a polyunsaturated
oil? No, there's no difference.
Basically the same.
But in the cookbook, I've been using actually the vegetable spray.
Vegetable spray,
yes.
Okay, is that a kind of?
Yes,
very good.
So we use very little oil here.
Oh, that's great. So you even conserve oil.
Yes, right.
Okay. And so what's so special about preparing a very healthy breakfast? You know, the people out there, it's like their fifth day of Simbang Gabi. That's really famous among Filipinos. And they want to know what's really special about a healthy breakfast. Explain to them why breakfast is so important, because they don't believe me.
Oh, breakfast is really very important because that's the start of the day. Now, others would skip meals. Especially breakfast, but you know the tendency here is if you skip your breakfast, you tend to eat more for lunch and dinner.
Now, if you eat a lot for dinner, that's not even going to digest anymore. That's all going to turn into fat.
Yes, right.
So you're actually better off having a really healthy breakfast, especially since it's Simbang Gabi. You wake up at like 3 o'clock to go to mass at 4 o'clock or something like that. So you need energy to keep you going throughout the whole day.
Right.
And not just any kind of breakfast. They should have a healthy breakfast. What, for example, would be a healthy breakfast to you?
Well, a healthy breakfast would always start with a fruit. And then I would, for me, for instance, I would go for an oatmeal.
Oatmeal.
And then probably have yogurt or have my milk with the oatmeal.
Okay. Now for people like me who hardly eat breakfast, when I do eat breakfast, I actually want something like atap silog, tosilog, corned beef and rice. Is that okay? Considering that's going to be like swimming in oil?
Well, that depends, because actually what I do here, when I give instructions to my clients, it's like this. I give them a food plan, like how many exchanges of vegetables, of fruits, meat group, that's what I mean. Meat group, and then the rice and the fat for the whole day, and then spread it out. Like I teach them how to that they have to spread it out, like they have for breakfast, they have breakfast, they have snack, lunch, snack, and dinner. That's how to eat healthy. Okay. You really spread out the food.
Okay. So don't forget, people, breakfast is the most important meal of the day, and don't worry about gaining weight because you have all day to burn it. So Miss Bana will cook for us a little later. She's going to have some food with oatmeal. So don't go away, because we'll be back with so much more at Health Central. If you just joined us and you have the Monday blues, worry not, because we are going to be making some fruity, nice breakfast for you. It's called fruited oatmeal, right?
Right.
And Miss Buena here, we're here at the Maya Kitchen, will explain to us why this particular oatmeal is more healthy than the regular oatmeal.
Yeah, because we make use of rolled oats, and this has more fiber than the instant rolled oats. Oh. And we also make use of the oat bran. It has lots of fiber. And we have, of course, the fruit.
Okay.
To go with it, and we have the fruit juice concentrate.
Okay, so we're ready to...
So our ingredients, of course, we have the water, we have the fruit juice concentrate, the rolled oats, we have here banana, we have
dried fruit,
this is dates, and we have ground fat meal, we have the oat bran, and then we have the cinnamon. Now we mix the water. And the fruit
water
juice.
The fruit juice. Concentrate.
And then
put the oatmeal.
The oatmeal.
The rolled oats.
Okay. We cook this for 5 minutes.
Cook for 4 to 5 minutes. And then we get the bananas. As you can see, we chopped it just a bit earlier, but to keep it from turning brown, we soaked it in some fruit juice.
Fruit juice, yes. And I just want to mention that half of the big banana is one fruit exchange.
Is all you need.
Yes. And we have also the dried the dates. It's 1/4 cup. It's also one fruit exchange, and we have the non-fat milk.
Okay. So for everyone out there, if you're interested in taking courses with Maya, you can call them at 892-11.
It's always nicer to use the rolled oats because it has more fiber. Now the instant oats has more sodium.
Yeah.
And you can prepare this ahead of time. You can prepare it in the evening and just reheat it the following morning.
Also, it's still good. It's,
yes, of course.
Still going to be nice
just
and fresh.
Just keep it in the refrigerator.
So you mean that you can even prepare it like for breakfast, and you can have it again for merienda?
Oh, yes, right.
Or maybe even breakfast the next day if you don't finish it up? Or no, you try to
Well, it's better
day.
That you just get what you need if you are preparing more servings.
Okay. Now, while I'm waiting for that to go, what's a nice, healthy drink that people can have for breakfast?
Well, we can have, usually, you know, people would like hot chocolate. We can have the hot cocoa.
Hot cocoa, hot chocolate, as opposed to the tea.
Not hot chocolate, because hot chocolate has fat. So in place of the chocolate, we use the cocoa.
Okay. As opposed to coffee and tea. I mean, those are okay to wake you up, but too much of that. Like if you have it every day, that we're talking, you know, every day for a year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, and you're gonna get all caffeined out.
I can put this in now.
So we're almost ready with it. Take some ingredients out. You can write to the Maya Kitchen to find out what it's gonna be like on January. Write to them at LCC, that's Lima Charlie at pacific.net.ph.
I'll have to mix this, so... Meantime, I'm cooking.
LCC@pacific.net.ph. So we mix it all in.
Yeah. It's better to mix it this way so it doesn't stick. It will easily dissolve.
So this is a good alternative for those that want to have a healthy breakfast.
Yes.
That's not too heavy.
Oh, this is heavy.
Oh, this is heavy?
This is
heavy.
Well,
it doesn't look heavy. So if you want to like psychologize yourself into thinking you're not having a heavy breakfast, fruited oatmeal is a good alternative. What about fruit juices. Do you think fruit juices are good to have for breakfast?
Well, I would prefer that you eat the fruit rather than drinking the juice, you know.
Oh, so it's actually more advisable to have the actual fruit in its original state rather than have it in the fruit juice. Okay.
Now, if my client is on a weight gaining diet, then I allow them lots of fruit juice. They can have that.
So you'd say that fruit juice actually makes you gain weight?
Not really, but you know, it's like this. With the fruit juice, you just drink it. Once you swallow, there's no more taste, you know. The taste bud is right here on the tongue. Now, but with
the fruit,
you chew it very well. And, you know, the taste registers in your brain, so.
That smells really good. That smells really good. So doesn't that look good?
Yeah, it looks good and smells good
too. And it smells really good too. So we'd like to thank Ms. Buena here from the Maya Kitchen for teaching us how to make the fruited oatmeal. But don't move. Don't change that dial. Don't even surf. Not even for 10 seconds, because when we come back, Ms. Buena here is going to show us how to make the cinnamon French toast.
You will need 1 medium-sized egg, 2 tablespoons oil, 3/4 cup water, and 1 250-gram package of Maya hotcake mix. First, beat the egg slightly in a bowl. Add in 2 tablespoons of oil and water to the egg mix. Add the hotcake mix and stir until just blended. There is no need to wait for the batter to become smooth, so do not overmix. Pour 1/3 cup batter onto a preheated pan. There is also no need to add extra oil to the pan if a Teflon-covered skillet is used. Also, there is no need to flatten the hotcakes. Maya hotcakes were made to rise to a fluffy height. Cook until bubbly. And flip to cook the other side. Use a Teflon-covered skillet to prevent sticking. The Maya hotcake mix is also available in an institutional size of 2 kilos for those interested in business opportunities. You can make an appointment with Ms. Rory C. Subida, the Maya Kitchen Manager, for a free business consultation. Call her at the telephone numbers 892-1185 or 892-5011, local 108 or 109.
Lovely Monday morning back here at the Health Central on the start of our Christmas week. We're here at the Maya Kitchen with Miss Buena. She's just taught us how to make the fruited oatmeal. And now we're going to move on to one of my favorites, the cinnamon French toast.
Okay, for our ingredients, we have whole egg, we have 2 egg whites, 1/4 cup non-fat milk, and we have, of course, the cinnamon to flavor. And we have the bread. Now what we do is we mix the whole egg.
Mix it in.
The 2 egg whites.
the egg whites.
And the milk.
And the milk.
And the cinnamon.
And the cinnamon. So why would you say this cinnamon French toast is healthier than the regular French toast?
Well, actually, if you'll notice, I used, instead of using two eggs, I used one whole egg plus two egg whites, so that lessens the cholesterol from the recipe.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's actually like this. The cholesterol that is present in one egg, well, actually depends on the size of the egg, would be from 220 to 260. And do you know that our allowance for one day is less than 300 milligrams?
Oh, okay.
So if we have two whole eggs, then we consume already our cholesterol.
Daily allowance or cholesterol.
So what we do here is we spray.
We spray the pan?
Yeah, we spray the pan.
Miss Buena here holds clinic at the Cardinal Santos. What room number are you in?
I'm at room 220B, Medical Arts Building.
Medical Arts Building, so everyone can just come over and get some advice. Do you have patients with age 6 to 60, right?
Yes, right.
So we spray it on the Teflon pan. Put it in.
Oops.
And you cook it.
Yeah.
And put it right over. It's a really easy process.
And so when the cinnamon... We just cook this to brown.
Wait for it to brown. Mm-hmm. I've always wondered, when the cinnamon toast is done, the French cinnamon toast, are you supposed to actually add syrup or butter?
Well,
you can eat it at the
You end? Can add jam or marmalade, or you can have fruit sauce.
Okay,
so it depends on what you really want.
I really love it with butter. Like when it's still hot, you put the butter right over and you can like melt it through.
But you know the butter, 1 teaspoon of the butter is 45 calories already.
Oh, what about the, I can't believe it's not butter.
Well, you can make use of that.
See,
no problem.
You're such butter fanatics. I can live on bread and butter. So there we have it. It's almost browning. For those of you interested in taking courses at the Maya, they have courses that last for days. Courses that last 3 to 4 days, and courses that last a whole week. So we'll come right over and take your lessons. If you want to find out their schedules, call them at 892-1185. And here at the Maya Kitchen, they have specialized courses by foreign chefs. Like if you want to learn how to cook food like of the Dutch, the Japanese, the French, you can come right over, and instead of having to go all the way to their country to learn how to cook, can take it right here. We have courses starting January, like they have the courses, like, which will last like on a weekly basis, that runs once a month.
Excuse me?
Which will second week of January.
We have to make sure that we use
a ladle,
plastic.
A plastic
for the
ladle.
Teflon pan, yeah.
Yeah, because you don't want to hurt the Teflon pan. You don't want to scratch it. Even when you wash the Teflon pan, right, Miss Buena, you cannot use those wiry things.
Yes,
you have
right.
to use like the soft sponges. And
just
you have to wait
sponge.
Until it cools down. Like any other pan, or any other food for that matter, wait for it to cool down before you decide to wash it, or food, wait for it to cool down before you stuff it in a refrigerator. So it's slowly browning, as you can see over there. I will go ahead and dip the other two here, make myself useful, because this is what I'm gonna be having for breakfast. Ah,
it's almost done.
Move this.
Okay.
Cinnamon always is great. Everything is going to the world of cinnamon.
You know, the cinnamon and the vanilla can make the food taste sweeter.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Great. So it's actually already browning, right?
Yes.
Here at the Maya Kitchen, they have courses on catering courses, on restaurant operations, and basic cooking, basic baking, and domestic cooking. So there are a lot of things that you can do right over here. They even have like summer workshop for the kids. Like they have kids from like 6 to 12. And they have another course for like the juniors from ages 12 and above. So if the kids have nothing to do in summer, it's always best to get them doing something productive and creative rather than just staying home and playing PlayStation. Make them learn how to cook and be useful around the house, and they can be mom's little helpers. So So, here we are with a great way to have your breakfast. You have some fruited oatmeal over here and some cinnamon French toast. Cinnamon and French, what a great combination. Well, it's only like 5 days till Christmas time. We hope you guys have done with your Christmas shopping because by now the traffic's gonna get pretty bad and the prices might be even more expensive. Plus, if you like panic shop, you're gonna end up buying stuff that you don't really want and you're just gonna say, oh, this will do, which we don't want, right? Make sure if you're gonna give some stuff away for Christmas and it's food, try to make them healthy. That way you do a favor to the people you're giving the gifts to, okay? So, you're watching Health Central. I'm Rachel Del Mar. Join us again tomorrow, 10 to 10:30, every Monday through Friday, right here on ABC 5, because this whole week we're gonna be featuring the Maya Kitchen. See you tomorrow. Bye.